In this video, we'll take a look at how to run a factor analysis, or more specifically, we'll be running a principal components analysis in SPSS. And as we begin here, it's important to note, because it can get confusing in the field, that factor analysis is an umbrella term where the whole subject area is known as factor analysis, but within that subject, there's two types of main analyses that are run. The first type is called principal components analysis, and that's what we'll be running in SPSS today. And the other type is known as common factor analysis, and you'll see that come up sometimes. But in my experience, principal components analysis is the most commonly used procedure, and it's also the default procedure in SPSS. So in this example, as I said, we'll be running principal components analysis. And if you look on the screen here, you can see there's five variables, SWLS1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And what these variables are, they come from the items of the satisfaction with life scale, published by Diener et al. And what people do is they take these five items, they respond to the five items, where SWLS1 is, in most ways, my life is close to my ideal. And then we have the conditions of my life are excellent. I am satisfied with my life. So far, I've gotten the important things I want in life. And then SWLS5 is, if I could live my life over, I would change almost nothing. So what happens is the people respond to these five questions or items. And for each question, they have the following responses, which I've already input here into SPSS's value labels. Strongly disagree all the way through strongly agree, which gives us a 1 through 7 point scale for each question. So what we want to do here in our principal components analysis is we want to go ahead and analyze these five variables or items and see if we can reduce these five variables or items into one or a few components or factors, which explain the relationship among the variables. And I want to show you what I mean here, give you a little bit better idea about what I'm talking about, as it can become a little bit confusing in factor analysis. So let's go ahead and start by running a correlation matrix. And what we'll do is we'll go to Analyze, Correlate, Bivariate, and then we'll move these five variables over. Go ahead and click OK. And then here, notice we get the correlation matrix of SWLS1 through SWLS5. So these are all the intercorrelations that we have here. And if we look at this off diagonal, where these ones here are the diagonal, and they're just a one because a variable is correlated with itself, so that's always 1.0. And then the off diagonal here represents the correlations of the items with one another. So for example, this 0.531 here, notice it says in SPSS that the correlation is significant at the 0.01 level, two-tailed. So this here is the correlation between SWLS2 and SWLS1. This here is SWLS1 and 3, and then we have 1 and 4, 1 and 5, and so on. So all of these in this triangle here indicate the correlation between the different variables or items on the satisfaction with life scale. And what we want to see here in factor analysis, which we're about to run, is that these variables are correlated with one another, and at a minimum, significantly so. Because what factor analysis or principal components analysis does is that it analyzes the correlations or relationships between our variables. And basically, we try to determine a smaller number of variables that can explain these correlations. So notice here we're starting with five variables, SWLS1 through 5. Well, hopefully in this analysis, when we run our factor analysis, we'll come out with one component that does a good job of explaining all these correlations here. And one of the key points of factor analysis is it's a data reduction technique. And what that means is we enter a certain number of variables, like 5 in this example, or even 20 or 50 or what have you, and we hope to reduce those variables down to just a few. Between 1 and, let's say, 5 or 6 is most of the solutions that I see. Now, in this case, since we have 5 variables, We really want to reduce this down to one or two at most, but one would be good in this case. So that's really a key point of factor analysis. We take a number of variables and we try to explain the correlations between those variables through a smaller number of factors or components. And by doing that, what we do is we get a more parsimonious solution, a more succinct solution that explains these variables or relationships. And there's a lot of applications of factor analysis, but one of the primary ones is when you're analyzing scales or items on a scale and you want to see how that scale turns out. So how many dimensions or factors does it have to it? So let's go ahead and get started with our factor analysis. And as we move through the analysis in SPSS, I'll explain various pieces of it so that when we get done, you should have a pretty good understanding of what a factor analysis is and how to go about running one. So let's go ahead and get started.